A very good morning, all of you. Welcome to the lab session 3.1. So before proceeding to this video, please watch the lab session 3, where we have discussed how to find the largest number among the given 5 numbers or 4 numbers. So we are going to use the same program and try to do some modification to find out smallest number among the given numbers which are stored in a memory location. Now we'll try to see smallest number, okay? I'll just close the debug session. See, for the smallest number, you don't have to change anything except only one line. So instead of JNC, you just type JC. Please remember, you are supposed to write everything same. Only condition you have to change is at ninth line, you are supposed to make a jump, a carry to the L2 line. Whenever there is a carry, you jump to the L2 line. Otherwise, execute the next instruction. Now we'll try to see that program in a moment. I'm going to open the smallest number among the given. Program will be same. I'm not going to change anything except that one line. You can see here, everything is same. Your origin is same. Your counter value is same. Your R0 also same memory location. Your instruction, your back, L1, L2, everything same. Only JC is changed. Previously it was JNC, now it is JC. Previously JNC means jump, no carry. Now, whenever there is a carry, you are supposed to jump to the L2 line. So only difference. Now I am going to execute and show you how this is going to find out the smallest number among the given numbers. Okay, fine. So
now let us take 5 numbers in the memory location: 15, 10, then 1, then 5, then 9.
Yeah, fine, okay. Now we took the 5 numbers. We know it's very clearly the 1 is the lowest number that we are going to verify using step by step, okay. So first we'll start first step. In the first step, your counter is set to 4 and your R0 set to 12 like your previous program. Then I'm going to increase my R0 to next location, that will be 13. Whatever the value at 12 memory location, that move to A register. If at 12 memory location you are having 15, that 15 is moved to accumulate register. In the next instruction, your R0 will be incremented, becomes 13. At 13 memory location value will move to the B register. So the 10 is moved to the B register. Now it is going to compare A and B. If you look at here, A and B are not equal. When they are not equal, it's supposed to jump to the L1 line. So if I execute the next instruction, it goes to the L1 line. It goes to L1 line. Now here is the important point. If you look at here, JC L2, that means jump whenever there is a carry to the L2 line. If you look at here, your 15 and 10, okay. Is there any possibility for the carry generation or carry flag generation? 15 is greater than 10, so no carry flag will be generated. Okay, so in that case, your jump carry L2 instruction will not execute because there is no carry generated. So what it does is go to the next instruction. That means next instruction is move A comma B. That means whatever the value in B, that goes to the A register. That means lowest number will move to the A register. Please remember, this instruction execute only whenever there is a carry flag involved. In these two numbers, there is no possibility when you compare the carry flag generation, so it goes to the next line. In the next instruction, it goes to move A comma B. So whatever the value B, that will move to the accumulate register. Now if you execute, your A becomes 10. You can see A becomes 10. Now it goes to the counter line, where it's going to decrease my R7 value. So if I execute the next instruction, R7 value becomes 3 and goes to the loop. Again, it's going to increase my R0. That means it becomes 14. At 14 memory location, I'm having 1. That 1 value will move to the B register. You can see your B value is 1. Your 1 value will compare with the 10. Since both are not equal, it goes to the L1 line. At L1 line, jump carry. So if you look at here, 10 is greater than 1, so there is no possibility for the carry flag. which execute the next instruction, that is move A comma B. So that means if you look at here, move A comma B. Whatever the B value, that was 1, move to the accumulator register. Accumulator register is 1 now. Now again, my R7 will be decreased and check for 0. If I decrease my R7, it becomes 2, not equal to 0. Again, it goes to the loop. So it becomes 2 and went to the loop. Again, my R0 will be incremented to 15 memory location. At 15 memory location, I'm having 5. That 5 will be moved to the B register. Now it's going to compare 1 and 5. Now here is the cache, please remember. Now both are not equals. When both are not equal, suppose take a jump to L1 line. I took to L1 line. Now if you look at here, 1 and 5, now carry flag will generate because A1 is less than, your A is less than B. Your carry flag will be generated. Whenever there is a carry, it is asking us to jump to the L2 line. Asking us to skip this move A comma B instruction, it's just asking us to jump to the L2 line. That means whenever A is less than B, it just jumped to the L2 line. That means it's going to skip the move A comma B instruction. Now it goes to the L2 line. That means your A is already having lowest number compared to the B register value. So it's taking same value. Now I'm going to decrease my R7 value by one more number. It becomes 1. And again, it goes to the loop. Again, increase the R0 value to 16. At 16 memory location, I'm having 9. 9 will be moved to the B register. Again, it's compare A and B. Both are not equal. So take a jump to L1 line. At L1 line, look for the carry. If you look at here, the carry flag is there because 1 is less than 9. So whenever there is a carry flag, it's supposed to jump to the L2 line. L2 line means it's supposed to decrease the R7 value. So R7 value becomes 0 this time and your loop will be terminated. So if you look at here, your accumulator is having the lowest number among given 5 numbers. Hope it is clear, all of you.
Now let us try with two equal numbers. Instead of arbitrary numbers, I'm taking two equal numbers. I'm making my one as 5.
Okay, now we'll execute. We'll just reset the numbers. So first instruction, your counter has made it to 4. Then R0 loaded with 12, a 12 memory location value move to accumulator register, that is 15. Okay. Then increment R0, then move to B register and compare 15 and 10. Okay. Then both are not equal. You take a jump to L1 line. At L1 line, jump carry. Now there is no possibility for the jump carry. There is no possibility of the carry flag. So it's going to exchange the number. That means you are going to execute move A comma B. Okay, when A comma B executed, your accumulator will replaced with 10. 15 will be replaced by 10. Okay, now you check for the counter, your counter value R7. It decreased to 3, not equal to 0. It goes to the loop. Again, it increased to R0. Now it is going to take the 5. Now we'll focus on step by step. Now the 5 value will be moved to the B register. Okay, now it's going to compare A and B, 10 and 5. Both are not equal. Suppose take a jump to L1 line. At L1 line, jump carry. There is no possibility for the carry flag. So it goes to the move A comma B instruction. I see move A comma B instruction going to execute in a moment. Now the 10 will be replaced by 5. You can see a 5 is replaced. Like your 10 is replaced by 5. Again, check for R7 whether it is 0 or not. If it is not 0, again, it goes to the back loop. So it decreased the value and went to the back loop. I'm going to increase my R0, that means 15. At 15 memory location, I'm having 5. Now A and B are 5. Look at here. When both are equal, there is no jump instruction takes place. Supposed to go to the edge jump L2. Okay, is it clear? So this is what you want to test it, I guess. So when both are not equal only, jump will take place. This instruction will take the jump. If both are equal, it goes to the next instruction. That means edge jump L2. As you can see, it went to the example 2. Example 2 is directly here because when both are same, there's nothing like smaller or greater. You can take any number. So it keeps the same number. Accumulator will no need to change. So it directly goes to the L2 line and try to decrease your R7 value. So you can see directly it went to L2 line. And your R7 will be decreased by one more number, becomes 1. and your R0 will be increased by one more number, that becomes 16. At 16 memory location, you are having 9. 9 will be transferred to B register, and 5 and 9 will be compared. So both are not equal, so you take a jump to L1 line. At L1 line, jump carry. Now if you look at here, so 5 is less than 9, so there is a possibility for the carry flag. Whenever there is a carry flag, it's supposed to jump to L2 line. When jump to L2 line, your R7 going to decrease its value by one more, so it becomes 0. So your program is ended. So if you look at here, your accumulator is having lowest number among given 5 number, that is 5.